Welcome friends. Today we are going to see problems on beams with unsymmetric sections like T section, L section and I section. Okay. We already seen the problems based on symmetric sections, that is shear stress distribution diagrams. Okay. Today we are going to see on unsymmetric sections. The problem is a simply supported beam carries a UDL of 80 kilonewton per meter over the entire span of 6 meter. The cross section of the beam is T section, having flange 150 mm into 50 mm and wave 50 mm into 150 mm. Calculate the maximum shear stress for the section of the beam. Also draw shear stress distribution diagram. That means in that problem statement, they are not given the shear force. Okay, we have to calculate. Okay, they are given that there is what a simply supported beam carries a UDL of 80 kilonewton per meter over entire span of 6 meter. This is what a simply supported beam. This is what UDL. Okay, and this is a span. Okay, so RA is equal to RB. RA means this is what this support, that is RA, and this is what RB. Okay, RA is equal to RB is equal to W into L divided by 2. That means W is what 80 into L is what 6 divided by 2. It comes around 240 kilonewton. So simply RA is equal to RB is equal to 240 into 10 raised to 3 newton. This is nothing but what shear force. Okay, next is what the dimensions of T section is given. That is flange 150 mm into 50 mm, that is 150 into this 50. Okay, this is what flange. Then what about the web? Web is what 50 mm into 150 mm. That means this 50 mm wide and 150 mm deep. Okay, so first thing is that we have to find out Y bar, that is distance of CG from top bottom face or top surface. Okay, so Y bar is nothing but a1 y1 plus a2 y2 divided by a1 plus a2. So a1 is nothing but, suppose consider this is what section 1, this is what section 2. Okay, and then a1 is nothing but area of this section 1. Okay, and y1 is nothing but what the center of this section. Okay, or CG point of this section. So A1 is nothing but what? This 50 into 150. Okay. This is what 50 into 150 into this is total deep is 150 mm deep. So center point is what? At the 75 mm from this bottom. Okay. This is what 75. Plus this A2, 150 into 50. That is 150 mm wide and 50 mm deep. This is A2. Plus into Y2. Y2 is nothing but what? Y2 is what? This 150 plus this 50 divided by 2, total deep is what 50, so it comes around what 175. Okay, divided by a1 plus a2. a1 is what 50 into 150 plus a2 150 into 50. So Y bar comes around 125 mm from this bottom surface. From bottom 125 mm, from top it comes around 75 mm. Okay, this is what Y bar. Next, we have to find out moment of inertia of this total T section. So, we further taken I is equal to I1 plus I2. That means I1 means moment of inertia of this section 1 and I2 is nothing but what? Moment of inertia of this section 2. So, simply formula is that BD cube by 12 plus AH square. So, in section 1, B1 D1 cube by 12 plus A1 H1 square. So B is what in this section? B is what 50 into D is what 150. 150 cube divided by 12 plus A1 area of this section 1, 50 into 150 into H. H is nothing but what Y bar minus Y1. Y1 is what here 75. So is 125 minus 75 bracket square. Next, I2 is nothing but what moment of inertia of section 2. This is what? B2 D2 cube divided by 12 plus A2 H2 square. So here B is what? 150. This is what? B 150 into this depth. This is what? 50 mm. I write down here. Okay. 50 cube divided by 12 plus this area A2. 150 into 50 into this is what? Y bar minus what your Y2. This is what? Here. So simply by adding these two, we directly get Y. Y is equal to what? Y1 plus Y2. We got the value 53.125 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Okay. Now next, shear stress at top flange at the junction of top flange and wave. So here, first thing is that here shear stress will be zero, and at this point shear stress also zero. First thing we have to find out at this point, this is what? Top flange and junction of this flange and wave, this point. Next, at this point, and third one is at this point, we have to find out. This is what? Suppose this is a toe 1, this is what? Toe 2, and this is what? Toe max. Okay, so first thing is that toe 1. Now, to find out the shear stress, the formula, simple formula is there. S into A into Y bar divided by B into I. So, S is what? 240 into 10 raised to 3 into area. 150 into 50 into, this is Y bar, 50. That means, from here up to here, okay, total distance is what? 75 minus this 25, because total depth is what? 50. 50 divided by 2, that is 25. From, we have to minus from top 25 mm. 75 minus 25, that comes around 50. We can take value 50 here. Okay. Divided by B into I. B is what? 150 into this I. So we got value 11.29 Newton per mm square. That is what? Toe 1. Okay. Next. Toe 2. Toe 2 is nothing but what? Shear stress in the wave at junction of top flange and wave. Okay. So toe 2 is equal to S into A into Y bar divided by B into I. So S is nothing but what? 240 into 10 raised to 3. Okay. Into. This is what? A. 150 into 50. Into. Y bar. This is what? 50. Divided by. B is what? 50 here. Here 150. Here 50. Into this I. It comes around 33.88 Newton per mm square. So see here. At this point. Toe 2. Okay. So simply. This is what? B. Okay. This is what? 50. So we take 50 here. So value comes around here. Next, the maximum shear stress is equal to what? Shear stress at neutral axis. Consider area above neutral axis. That means we have to consider this area. Okay. Above neutral axis. Okay. So this is 150 into 50. Okay. Again, from neutral axis up to this point, this distance is nothing but what? 25 mm. So toe max is equal to toe at neutral axis equal to S into A into Y bar divided by B into I. So S is equal to what? 240 into 10 raised to 3 into, now this is what? This 150 into this 50. Okay. Into this 50. That means this 25 plus 50 divided by 2. That means 25. 25 plus 25, this comes around what? 50. Plus, now next is what? This 50 into this 25, this is what? Area into this 25 divided by 2, that is 12.5, divided by B into I. B is nothing but what? This is what? 50 mm wide is there, and this is what? I. So value toe max is equal to what? 35.29 Newton per mm square. This is what we got the values, that is toe 1, toe 2 and toe maximum. From this value we draw here shear stress distribution diagram. That means at top shear stress is 0. Next is toe 1. Toe 1 is equal to what? 11.29. Okay. this is. Okay, next TO2 is equal to what? 33.88. okay, and this is what TO max, that is maximum shear stress, that is at neutral axis. This is nothing but what? 35.29. and at this point this is what? Zero. This is what shear stress distribution diagram. Okay, thank you.